Hello and welcome. My name is Darren and welcome to our channel. Today I'm going to do a pencil shading demonstration. I'm using two pieces of paper here because I like to have an extra piece underneath to give me some more extra padding under my paper. So we're going to imagine there's some light coming through our window. So at the moment, we have light coming through in this direction. So if I place my fingers down, you can see the shadows that are casting around my fingers here. So we're going to do the same with an object. So I'm going to make a cone. I hope you can see that. Placing the camera isn't easy, but today the lighting's very good. So we got the sun heading in this direction here. So initially there wouldn't be any line here because of the sun. So what we could do is eliminate that line very slightly, okay, because I just drew it down a little bit too hard. That's a bit better. So we're going to cast a shadow. We're going to use the same shape we have there. Now, there's different methods of drawing. You can do crisscrosses, circles, swirls, but I tend to just draw lines. Now, the line has to be straight. Sunlight doesn't curve around corners, so we're going to go light across here and then fade to nothing. So here we go. I'm turning my pencil in the direction of the cylinder so it retains its shape. It takes a bit of practice. I could use a bigger pencil. Maybe if I use a piece of charcoal or a bigger ended pencil, I may be able to draw a lot faster. So I'm just gradually, slightly. So you press down too hard, you'll tend to permanently leave a mark there. It'll be very hard to blend over it. Now, depending on what sort of pencil you're using, don't try and turn your lead around because the lead on the other side of your pencil will be sharper, so you end up getting a darker line impressed into your paper. I've got a nice flat edge here on my pencil now. Just gradually with my lines. Here. Two B pencils seems to have a softer feel about it. The four B's are a lot darker. Now if I turn my lead around, turn it around like this. Edge of the pencil here will be sharper, and you'll see that when I press down on the paper. It's good when you want to add some detail parts to your drawing, just turn your pencil around. You know when it's right. You just keep going until you think it's, yeah, I'm happy with that. Now, put a dark line around the bottom here. Give myself some shape here. Better, and maybe see, I've turned my pencil around, give it a nice sharp edge there up here. Takes a bit of getting used to. You can always come back and use your rubber and remove excess pencil, but I try and not do that. I like the challenge. Doesn't matter if you make a mistake. You're learning all the time. Even with all the years I've drawn, I'm always learning. Yeah, always learning. Just press that pencil to the paper. We're going to put a little ledge to the top here. casting a shadow. Happy with this top here. I'm happy with that little bit there, so I'm going to rub that part out. You know why? Because I can. Because I can do whatever I want. That's better. Maybe take a little bit off the end there. I'm not going to stop until I'm happy. My drawing. Yeah, looking a lot better. Get another pencil like I've got here. It's got a sharp edge on it. Amazing. By sharpening your pencil, you can make it go darker. Now, let's do the shading part. You can leave a little bit of a line around the edge there, but you won't need to, because the shading of the cylinder is quite light as it is now. Next time, I'll do one that's got a different shape than a cylinder. Like that.
shadow is going to be longer than the item, because where the sun is positioned, because it's further down. So the further down it is here, the further the shadow is cast. Making the shadow a lot thinner. I'll carry on with this until all the lines are going in one direction. This part here darker. I hang some lines across here like this. Lines are a great way of giving something a shape. Your eyes tend to follow the lines around an object. Nice. I'll do some more around here. There you go. That's a cylinder. I'm going to put my name here, my initials.
Lines are a great way of keeping something under control. There you go. One cylinder. I might just take that little line out there. Make it a little bit lighter across there, like that. That's better. Because I can do whatever I want. I might just take a little bit off there as well. Very lightly. Come down. And thank you so much for watching. Keep watching, because you never know, we may upload another video like this soon. So please follow us on our channel, because we'd love to have you. Bye now. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.